मैं
करो
जब
तो आई कंट्रोल
Students, whatever we are going to deal today, it is a new point, so everyone needs to write it. Okay, see here. Actually, I told you task one and task two, but the sheet which was given to you was of exercise. So today you'll get that question of task. Separate additional question we have framed. So task one and task two. Monday you need to solve it and bring. No. There will be separate questions will be given to you. It will be given with a soft copy that it will be there on WhatsApp today. There are such questions that you can easily solve. This question are mixed question. Whatever sheet you got is mixed question. Unless complete topic is taught, you are not able to solve it. Because two, three concept questions are framed. Did you get it? So whatever today on WhatsApp group, I will send the task, that two tasks you need to solve. Are you getting it? Okay, online hours are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So today, what we are going to see a new topic known as photoelectric effect. So write down photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect. It was given by scientist Hertz. Okay, first try to understand what is photoelectric effect. Then whatever notes I will give you, that you write down. First try to understand what is photoelectric effect. So everyone should look here. Okay. Now, see here. Like this one, discharge tube was taken. And two electrodes were connected with the battery. Now tell me, the electrode which is attached to negative terminal is called cathode. So this terminal is cathode, and which is attached to positive terminal, it is anode. Okay. Here, vacuum pump was situated, so all the air from these two was removed out. So here vacuum is there now. Now what is meant by photoelectric effect? This word photo means light, light energy, and this electric means, you know, current. So by using light energy, we need to produce current. Are you getting it? Photoelectric effect means what? By using light, we need to produce current. Okay. Now, whether the electricity is produced or not, to calculate it, here ammeter was connected. Now, suppose this is an incident light. This is an incident light, or we can say photon. If it strikes this metal surface. If this strikes this metal surface, now which metal surface to take? Which has low ionization potential? Which has low ionization potential, because from this we need to remove electron. So those metal which can give electron easily, that particular metal we need to place it here. Now tell me which metal in periodic table can give electron easily. Do you know the concept of ionization potential? Just tell me. No. Okay, now see here. At least this much you know, in our periodic table there are some metals, some are non-metals and some are metalloids. So can you give me some example of metals? Okay, do you know alkali metals? Group 1?
Yes, sir.
Group 1 is called as alkali metals, correct? Can you tell me which are they? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Correct? And do you know that while moving from left to right, atomic size decreases? So in this period, lithium will be having highest size. Lithium will be highest size. And metals are those which donate electrons. Metals are which donate electron. Look here now. Suppose we will talk about lithium. What is the atomic number of lithium? Yes. Helium is 2. So lithium is 3. So what will be its electronic configuration? 2, 1. In order to become stable, either duplet should be completed or octet should be completed. Means, will it take 7 electron or give 1 electron? It is better to give 1 electron. So it loses this one electron. Now, is duplet completed? Yes, so how many electron it has lost? So we write lithium as +1. This much you understood? Okay. Means these are the metals which can donate electron. And in photoelectric effect, we need to take such metal which can donate electron. So these are the metals which can donate electron and whose size is bigger. Out of this, as we move from top to bottom in the group, this is group 1 element. As we move from top to bottom in the group, what increases? Size increases. This is period 2, period 3, 4, 5, 6. Down, size increases. So who will be having highest size in this? Cesium. So who can donate electron easily? Cesium. All are good electron donors. All are good electron donors. But we want best electron donor. Who is best electron donor? Cesium. So for photoelectric effect, either you can take cesium, rubidium or potassium. But who is the most easy electron donating? Cesium. Understood? So which metal they are taken here? But in book it is mentioned that either you can take cesium, rubidium or potassium. Or because they are also good electron donor. But who is the most likely to give electron? That is cesium. Any doubt in this? So when this incident light falls on the group, here we want a metal which can donate electron easily. Okay, now tell me, students. This is the nucleus. This is a nucleus. These are different shells. Okay, nucleus, it has proton and neutron. Neutron is neutral. Proton is positive. Neutrons are the different shells, correct? Yes. So the incident light will strike this electron and we need to remove this electron. To produce electricity, we need to remove that electron. But tell me, this proton and this electron, some force of attraction will be there? Yes, which is this force of attraction? Electrostatic force of attraction. This will oppositely charge particles. So this incident energy should overcome this binding energy. No? So we will say this is binding energy.
Binding energy.
Drop.
means your incident energy should be greater than the binding energy. Then only what will happen? The electron will come out. Suppose you just imagine that is 8 joules of energy is required to remove this electron. How much? 8 joules. Just imagine 8 joules are required to remove this electron. And if you provide 10 joules of energy, if you provide 10 joules of energy, so will this electron come out? Or at least stop. Will this electron come out? Definitely this electron will come out, because how much energy is required to remove this electron? 8 joules. Means 8 joules will be required to remove this electron. So the electron has come to the surface. And extra, how much energy is there with us? 2 joules. So that is nothing but the kinetic energy of this electron, that is 2 joules. And suppose this is a positive terminal, so this electron will be here, it is a collector, then emitter will show some deflection. Means what is produced? Electricity is produced. So can I say the minimum minimum energy to remove this electron is how much? 8 joules. Suppose if I use 5 joules of energy, will that electron come out? No. So this energy should be greater than binding energy, then only electron will come out, and that extra energy will be used for its kinetic energy. Is this point clear? So that we say it as threshold energy. Threshold energy. So threshold energy is minimum energy to required to remove the electron. So what is the threshold energy here? 8 joules, minimum amount of energy. If extra is there, that extra will be means that will be utilized for kinetic energy. But minimum, how much energy is required? 8 joules. Students, this is only for you to understand. 8 joules. It's not 8 joules. Only so that you should understand. So, did you understand what is threshold energy? Minimum energy required to remove electron from the metal surface is called as threshold energy. Any problem in this? Minimum energy. And here one work function we use here. One work function. Do you know what is this work function called? This symbol. This is called as phi.
Phi
is nothing but minimum threshold energy, which is also denoted by phi. This is called as phi. So phi is nothing but minimum energy to remove this electron from the metal surface. So if in exam it is asked, what is threshold energy? Threshold energy is minimum energy required to remove electron from metal surface. Or can I say minimum energy to produce photoelectric effect? Okay. And then if we should answer. So this scientist had done this experiment, but he was not able to explain why this electricity is produce. He did this experiment, that is photoelectric effect, but he was not able to explain how this current is generated. Then came a scientist, Einstein, and using Planck's quantum theory, he explained this concept. Now, yesterday's Planck's quantum theory, what was the observation? What formulas we used? Okay, first formula, I think so we used E is directly proportional to frequency. So instead of this proportionality, what we put? Planck's constant. Instead of this, what we put? C by lambda. So again, can anybody tell me what is threshold energy? Minimum energy is required to remove electron from metal surface. Okay. Is this E directly proportional to frequency? So can I say what is threshold frequency? Minimum frequency required to remove electron from metal surface, because E is directly proportional to mu. If this is threshold energy, this will be threshold frequency. We put just not to E not to understand this is threshold energy. So here it will be mu not. That will be threshold frequency. Now just see what is the relations between A and this wavelength? Inverse ratio, no? So can I say this was threshold energy, this was threshold frequency. What is threshold wavelength? Again, I am repeating here. Did you understand threshold energy? Minimum energy required to remove electron from the metal surface is called as threshold energy. E is directly proportional to mu. So threshold frequency means same definition, only minimum frequency required to remove electron from metal surface. Then what is threshold wavelength? Yes. Can you, if two definitions are done, you can write this definition. Yes. Is it minimum or maximum? Maximum, because it's inverse ratio. So then definition will change now. The maximum wavelength required to remove electron from metal surface. So all these three definitions are clear. Threshold energy, threshold frequency, and threshold wavelength. And from this we are going to create some formula. But at least this theory you understood. So write down the heading photoelectric effect. Okay, when certain metal, write down, when certain metal, in bracket you write down, with certain metal, potassium, that is K, rubidium, Rb, cesium, etc. But who is the most likely to give electron? Cesium. When exposed to beam of light, what will happen when light is exposed to beam of light? When that light strikes that metal surface, what will happen? Electron is ejected. So write down, electron is ejected. This is called as photoelectric effect. So write down work function phi like this symbol. Work function phi. Phi is nothing but threshold energy only, no? So what is the definition of it? Work function phi is, or threshold energy is, tell me, the work function phi or threshold energy is, what is the definition? The minimum energy required to remove electron from the metal surface, right on. You can see it as work function or threshold energy. Both are same. That is minimum amount of energy required to remove electron from metal surface. So I think so similarly you can write what is threshold frequency. Yes, right on, threshold frequency. Minimum frequency required to remove electron from metal surface. That is threshold frequency. And finally, you can write threshold wavelength. Maximum wavelength. For wavelength, you need to write maximum wavelength required to remove electron from metal surface. Okay, see here now. Look here, now I'm going to give you three conditions. So, condition first. If the energy, can I write energy as H mu? If this is threshold energy is greater than what we have put the energy. This is the energy required to remove the electron. And this is the energy which we have incident. This is the energy which we have incident on this metal surface. If that incident energy is less than this threshold energy, what will happen? Means can I write photoelectric effect will not take place? Means electron won't be ejected. Suppose 8 joules energy is required and we are just providing 4 joules, will electron come out? So in this case, you need to write photoelectric effect will not be observed or will not take place. So first condition, write on photoelectric effect won't be observed. If H mu is smaller than that is work function. Yes, second condition, if this is equal, then the threshold energy which is required to remove electron and whatever electron we have provided is equal, photoelectric effect will be observed, but electron will just come on the surface. It will not have kinetic energy. See here. How much energy is required to remove this electron? Suppose 8 joules. And we are just providing how much joules? 8 joules only. Only electron will come on the surface. It will not move. So write on. Here you can write photoelectric effect will be observed, but electron will not have kinetic energy. But electron will not have kinetic energy. So can I write here kinetic energy will be zero? And third condition, now you might have understood what is third condition. Now this is greater. Incident energy is greater than the threshold energy. Photoelectric effect will be observed and electron also will have kinetic energy. Means kinetic energy will not be equal to zero. Is this correct? So this is the incident energy. This is the electron which we want to remove. Suppose 8 joules are required. So if we provide 12 joules, so it will even have what? Kinetic energy. These three conditions you understood? Now we'll be writing some formulas. So write down. Energy of incident light, that is we denoted by E, that is equal to H mu. This we have brought from Planck's quantum theory, correct? E is equal to H mu, the energy of incident light. This is ionization energy. What is ionization energy? Minimum energy required to remove that electron from the attraction of nucleus. So can I write it H mu naught? This is nothing but threshold energy only, no? This is nothing but phi, threshold energy. At least that much energy is required so that we can overcome the nucleus force and we can at least remove the electron. And if you provide more energy, that electron will move. Yes. Third one. Kinetic energy, everyone knows the formula. What is that? 1/2 mv². 1/2 mv². Okay. Now, this is the light which we have incident. Now, this light which we have incident will do two work. What is the first work? First, it will remove that electron. And then, whatever is left energy, that will go into kinetic energy. So, two work it is doing. What that two work? One is phi. Phi is what at least minimum energy required to remove that electron. And whatever left energy will be there, that will be in the form of kinetic energy. Now, just substitute the value. E is given by H mu. Phi is given by H mu naught, and kinetic energy is given by 1/2 mv². So can we prepare different forms? Instead of mu, can I write C by lambda? Here can I write C by lambda naught? You make one more formula. Instead of this, I can write Hc by lambda. Hc by lambda naught plus 1/2 mv². So these are the formulas which you need to use. Okay, one more formula I'm going to mix here. Close that. Okay. E of light is equal to phi plus kinetic energy. Is this correct? Okay. E of light what? H mu. That is equal to H mu naught plus kinetic energy. So how we can write kinetic energy? Tell me. H mu minus H mu naught. Can we take H as common? So what will be the formula? Okay, instead of mu, can you put C by lambda? That will be one more formula. Write down. So can I write instead of kinetic energy 1/2 mv² Okay, now tell me, photoelectric effect. So some light has come and strike that electron. That electron has came out, correct? No, it has come out. Now that means what? This light, which is incident, It is having dual nature. What is that dual nature? It is in wave form. Up till now, we have seen electromagnetic waves. It is in wave form. But this experiment proved that it is also in particle form. And will wave remove that electron? No, something has strike that electron, means it's the particle. So from this photoelectric effect, we understood this light is not just a wave, it is also in particle form. So we in books we read dual nature of light. So it is particle form as well as wave form. Because this something might have strike, then only this electron will come out. Okay, do you remember the story of electron, the discharge tube? That scientist who discovered electron, J.J. Thomson. In between some experiment, what he had done, he had put small wheels in between. He had put small wheels in that tube, and then he suddenly seen that this wheel started rotating. Will wave rotate that wheel? Something might have struck that wheel. Then it starts rotating. That means what? The light has a dual nature. What is that dual nature? It is in wave form, that is electromagnetic waves, as well as particle form. If in MCQ if it is asked, photoelectric effect is evidence that it is a particle nature. Is it correct? Definitely, it's photoelectric effect. What it says that something has strike that electron, and then electron is ejected. Means whatever is strike, that is in particle form. Got it? So some important points are there. So write down some important points. Write down some important points. First point, photoelectric effect is an evidence of particle nature of light. Photoelectric effect is an evidence of particle nature of light. Is this statement correct? Yes. Okay. Second one. Photo. Should I repeat the first point? Photoelectric effect is an evidence of particle nature of light. It proves that light is having particle nature. And already we have seen, up till now we have seen it is having wave nature. Now this experiment proved that particle nature. So can I say now onwards that it is dual nature, particle as well as wave? Second point, kinetic energy of electron. In short you can write kinetic energy of electron increases in increase in frequency of light. Kinetic energy increases with increase in frequency of light. See here now. This is the metal surface. This is the incident light. Suppose 8 joules of energy is required to remove this electron. And how much we have provided? 10. So rest energy will be, instead of 10, if I take 12, kinetic energy will increase. Here I take 20, kinetic energy will increase. Means if frequency is increased, the kinetic energy will increase. Next point. There is no time gap between, there is no time gap between There is no time gap between the striking of light and ejection of electron. Striking of light and ejection of electron. Means as soon as this light will strike this metal, immediately what will happen? This electron will be ejected. There is no time gap between them. First it will strike, after a few seconds it will be ejected. It's not like that. At the same point it gets ejected. So there is no time gap between the incident light and removing of this electron. It takes simultaneous. Next point. This is very important point now. The number of electron ejected. The number of electron ejected is proportional. Is proportional to intensity of light. To intensity of light, or you can write brightness of light. Brightness of light. See here, what is this point called? See here, again read this point clearly. The number of electron ejected is directly proportional to intensity of light. Intensity of light means here. Now look here. Suppose, just imagine we have given one photon energy. One electron is removed. One photon energy is given, one electron is removed. If I give two photon, two electron will be removed. If I give three photon, three, four. So, if I am increasing the intensity, what will happen? Number of electron ejected will increase. Listen carefully. I am not increasing the frequency. I am not increasing the frequency. I am just number of photons I am increasing. Just imagine one photon is required to remove one electron. Just imagine like this. If I give you 10 photons, 10 electrons will be ejected. Its kinetic energy will not change. Kinetic energy depends upon frequency. Kinetic energy depends upon, instead of 8 joules is equal, if I give 10 joules, if I give 20 joules, then speed will increase. But intensity increases, number of electron increases, which are ejected. These two points, always there is a confusion. Frequency increases, the speed of electron will increase. Means what it will change? Kinetic energy. Here, just imagine 8 joules of energy is required to remove this electron. And if you provide 20 joules, remaining 12 joules will be converted into kinetic energy. That is called as frequency. We have changed the frequency. But intensity means what? Number of photons. One photon, one electron ejected. 10 photon, 20 photon, but it is not changing the kinetic energy. It is not changing the kinetic energy. Suppose one photon will eject this electron. Suppose one photon will eject this electron, and just imagine that kinetic energy, one photon will eject this electron, and kinetic energy, suppose it is 2 joules. If I give you 10 photon, how many electrons will be ejected? 10 electrons, and kinetic energy will be same. 2 joules, 2 joules, 2 joules. But number of electrons will increase. Number of electron will increase. Instead of ejecting electron, 10 photon, 10 ejected electron plus each electron will have 2 joules, 2 joules, 2 joules. Kinetic energy will not change. But when kinetic energy will change? When frequency will change. This point, students think, okay, frequency. Frequency means what? It requires 8 joules, I am providing 20 joules. Next time I am providing 40 joules. The speed of electron will increase. So that is frequency. And intensity means number of photons. One photon, two photon, three photon, four photon, depending upon that metal surface. So write down. This point you understood. Brightness of light. And in bracket for your understanding, write number of photons. So you'll understand. So number of photon increases. Number of electron ejected will increase. But its kinetic energy will not change. And next point, you yourself write down. So kinetic energy depends on what? Yes, write down. Kinetic energy depends upon frequency, and it does not depend upon intensity. So if I draw this graph here, if I draw this graph, here it is kinetic energy, and here is frequency. Frequency increases, kinetic energy increases. Like this graph will be there. But same graph I'll draw. Kinetic energy versus intensity of light. How I'll plot this graph? It will be straight, constant. So you should be able to read this graph. Frequency increases, kinetic energy will increase. But this graph will be like this. Because intensity will only decide how much electrons are ejected. It will not decide its speed. So these two graphs you should be able to read it. Understood?
Yes.
Roughly you draw this graph. Okay, last point of this photoelectric effect is stopping potential. Photoelectric effect is one point. The last point is that is stopping potential. What is stopping potential now? See here. Now, yes, is this a photoelectric effect? This is incident light. This is minimum amount of energy required to remove electron, and then this additional energy is in the form of kinetic energy. Okay, I want this electron. Okay, this electron is ejected, correct? No, but I don't want this electron to be ejected. I don't want this electron to be ejected. But what is the problem? Here, minimum amount of energy is required is 8 joules. Suppose that we are providing how much joules? 10 joules for our understanding. Well, so what is stopping potential? So what they have done? They have changed the terminal now. Now positive terminal. This has a negative terminal. Now this becomes a positive terminal. Now the incident light is it is put on this. So, but we'll increase the potential difference such that this electron is regained. It is not ejected. Are you getting it? We have changed the terminal now. Now this becomes a positive terminal, and we know, okay, two joules of energy is extra, and it is converted into kinetic energy. So the potential difference will increase. So now this plate will hold that electron, which was being ejected. It will hold because we have changed the terminal, and we have increased the potential difference. So what will happen? How much energy is was required to eject that electron plus kinetic energy? That much difference will increase here. So now electron won't be ejected. That is called as stopping potential. Means, can I say the minimum potential required so that electron should not be ejected? That is called as stopping potential. So you write down, then again once more I'll explain. Write down what is stopping potential. It is defined as the potential required it is potential required to stop ejection of electron. To stop ejection of electron from a metal surface. From a metal surface, when incident beam of when an incident beam of energy when incident beam of energy is greater than incident beam of energy is greater than work potential is greater than work potential of the metal is greater than work potential of metal is greater than work potential of metal. Now again I'll explain you see. First, this was which terminal? Negative terminal. This was some incident energy we have put, and our incident energy was greater than work function. It was greater than work function. So whatever energy was extra, it has converted into kinetic. Now we need to pull that electron back. Now we'll change the terminal. And we'll apply such potential difference because we know, okay, this was extra energy because of that electron was moving. So that much potential difference will increase. So now electron, it will pull it. So it will not allow that electron to be ejected. That is called as stopping potential. Understood what is stopping potential? Okay, just imagine 2 joules of energy was extra. So now we change the terminal and that much potential difference will increase it here. That much potential difference will increase it here. Now what will happen? The electron which was supposed to be ejected, now it won't be ejected. And that potential difference is nothing but called as stopping potential. Okay, now the stopping potential is denoted by V naught. That stopping potential is denoted by V naught. But my question to you is, okay, that was converted into kinetic energy. First, if this was a negative terminal, whatever extra energy was there, that was converted into kinetic energy. We have changed the terminal and we have increased the potential. So this is the potential by which that electron has stopped. But you know law of conservation of mass. Energy is conserved. It is changed from one form to another. Now first it was kinetic energy. Now which energy it will be there? Correct, potential energy, because electron is held back now. So there is no movement. So we can say which energy? And can I say electrostatic potential energy, because this terminal is negative and whatever we are holding, that is electron, that is negatively. If negative and positive particles are there, always we use one word called as electrostatic. So can I say kinetic energy is converted into electrostatic potential energy? Again, this was negative terminal. This was a beam of incident light was put on this. So 8 joules of energy was required to eject the electron. We have provided 10 joules. So remaining 2 joules will be now with the calculation we know. Okay, 2 joules of energy was extra because of that electron was moving. Now we have changed the terminal, and with that much only potential we have increased. Now the electron which was supposed to be ejected, it is pulled back. So electron is not ejected. Because first we know, okay, 2 joules was, we know the calculation, okay, 2 joules was extra. That much only potential difference will increase. So now electron which was supposed to be ejected, it is stopped. But that kinetic energy is converted into electrostatic potential energy. Because law of conservation of mass. Okay, some energy, it was kinetic energy, so it should change into another form of energy, so that is potential energy. But here electron was there, which is negative, this electrode is positive, negative positive means what electrostatic should come, so it is converted into electrostatic potential energy. So write down there, So can I write like this? Kinetic energy is converted into electrostatic potential energy. Here you can write according to the law of conservation of mass. Kinetic energy, you know, should be half mv square. Okay, what is the minimum potential difference required? That was V naught. Here you can write V naught is minimum potential required to stop the ejection of electron. Minimum potential difference required to stop ejection of electrons. So V naught into with what we are dealing with, we are dealing with electrons. So this will be the E. This is the magnitude of that electron, means charge. You know what is the charge on electron? Yes, but what is the value? -1.6 into 10⁻¹⁹. So this will be the formula. This E is magnitude of charge. V naught minimum potential required. Are that much current we need to increase now so that the electron is pulled back. Please, for example only, I said 10 joules. Huh? Some students will write in exam, okay, 8 joules are required to eject the electron. We are providing 10 joules. Just it was an example. Got it? So this formula you wrote, m half mv square is equal to. Before this, did we frame one formula for this photoelectric effect, kinetic energy is one formula we have framed. See there, h mu is equal to h mu naught plus kinetic energy. Same formula you copy. H mu is equal to h mu naught plus kinetic energy. H mu is equal to h mu naught plus kinetic energy. So instead of kinetic energy, can we substitute this? Half mv square is equal to V naught into E. So one more formula you got. Are students, this formula you have written? No. H mu is equal to H mu naught plus kinetic energy. Instead of kinetic energy, you put it here. So can I write in this form also? Like that, many formulas we can make plus these values. Got it? So see here, this is JEE exam. You should be able to convert this formula. Okay, this many formulas I have given in exam. Something additional they will ask. See here, what they do? They try to check your understanding. On one page, see here. On one page, I'll write all the formulas and I'll tell you to buy it. Okay, if you buy it, that things never you'll pass JEE because JEE will ask something extra. Are you getting it? So, did you understand photoelectric effect? Yes. Tell me what is photoelectric effect. Here now, don't look into notebook and tell me what do you understand by photoelectric effect. When the incident light is put on the metal surface, the electron is ejected. So by using the light energy, we are producing electricity. That is photoelectric effect. But we want such metal which can leave electron easily. Because if you provide too much, if you take such metal which will not leave electron easily, will photoelectric effect take place? So we want minimum energy so that electron will be ejected. So which metal to take which is having low IP, low ionization potential. Ionization potential is minimum amount of energy required to remove electron from the valence shell. Outermost shell only the electron we are removing, no? But who is not allowing us to remove that electron? Nucleus. That force is called as electrostatic force or binding force. So our energy which we are providing should be greater than that force. So our energy which is which we are providing as incident light it should be greater than that binding force. Or then we say, okay, minimum energy. So that binding force is nothing but we are divided by phi. At least this much energy is required so that the electron will come out. If you provide more energy than that, so after coming out, the rest energy will be converted into kinetic energy. Because this was a positive terminal. Your collector was there. At least that electron should reach that terminal. And then your emitter will show some deflection. That means what? They will understand, okay, electricity is produced. This Hertz did this experiment, but he was not able to explain it. Who explained it? Einstein explained it by using Planck's quantum theory. This is all mixed. By using Planck's quantum theory, he explained, because Planck's quantum already had mentioned he is equal to mu, or he is equal to h mu, or E is equal to hc upon lambda. So, okay, minimum energy, that is called as threshold energy. Then minimum frequency, threshold frequency, minimum frequency required to eject the electron. Then threshold wavelength, but E and wavelength is inversely proportional. So we can say maximum wavelength, not minimum now, maximum wavelength required to eject the electron from metal surface. And then we created some formulas. And then last point, recently the question was asked on stopping potential. Means that much, okay, 2 joules of energy is extra, so it is converted into kinetic energy. So we'll change the terminal, that much potential will increase, so that electron is not ejected, electron is held back. Okay, it is not moving, means the kinetic energy is converted into electrostatic potential energy. You understand this? So from here, variety of questions can be asked, some graphs can be asked. So you should be able to understand that graph. Okay? Any problem? Okay. So here, listen to me carefully. Now only I'll send you on WhatsApp, I'll send you all the tasks. Because whatever the sheet is given to you, unless the complete chapter is not done, you will not be able to solid, okay, few questions you will be able to solve, but most of the question, what is there, some part is taken from photoelectric effect, some part will be taken from Bohr's atomic model, and so the question is framed. JEE will always do it, because do you know in JEE number of questions are always less as compared to NEET. In NEET around 45 questions are there, chemistry, I'm talking about chemistry, 45 questions are there. Do you know how many questions are there for you? 25. Out of that, how many are MCQ based? Only 20. And 5 are integer based questions where you need to solve. But the main advantage of integer based question, do you know what is the main advantage? There is no negative mark. So those who are able to solve integer based question, 100% they will qualify the exam. But that should be too much accurate. And it's a computer-based exam, so there, that particular space will be there. Suppose the answer, it takes 12.2, and you got 12.39. Okay, after typing, you just say, okay, 12.2. After that, it is not typing, means it is taking only that how many digits? 3 digits. So, but they want exact answer, because if you, the clear answer is 12.2, and if you go 12.3, will it accept? Or it's not a human to do little bit corrections, it's computer, so exact answer it will take, otherwise it will say it is wrong answer. Are you getting it? Okay, okay, last 5 minutes, students.